Welcome to the introduction videos of LutraCAD. This is a video about designing an insole based on a 3D scan. You will find the steps needed for designing an insole from start to finish at the top of the toolbar. Now only 7 steps are visible, but this toolbar will change when we have chosen for full contact insole. We start by selecting the first step, choose type. A pop-up message will appear with 4 options for you to choose from. Full contact for an insole based on a 3D scan, orthopedic insole for pre-made 3D insoles, podiatric insole for an insole based on elements, and complete insoles for previously designed insoles which have been added to your personal library. To make an insole based on a 3D scan, we have to choose full contact insole. A new screen will appear where you will choose your insole pattern. Press OK. You will be asked to assign a shoe size. The 3D files will now be imported. To continue, 3 points need to be selected. Center of metatarsal 1, center of metatarsal 5, and center of the heel. The software will automatically put these 3 points on the ground. These 3 points need to be selected for both feet. Position the 3D scan inside the red pattern. To do this, first move the scan to the right position by selecting the scan with the left mouse button and move it by drag and drop, arrow keys on the keyboard, or with the arrows on the toolbar on the bottom left. It is possible that the scan needs to be rotated as well, which can be done by the rotate button on the left. For this, the software needs 3 points: center point of rotation, reference point, end point. The second option is using the middle button on the bottom left toolbar. With the left mouse button, the scan will rotate counterclockwise, and with the right mouse button, it will move clockwise. The shoe size can easily be adjusted with a button on the left toolbar. You will be asked for the new size, and the software will automatically resize the pattern. At the moment, we do not have any 2D scans for this client, so we can skip step 2, rotate 2D, and step 3, accept 2D. And move directly to step 4, insole height. Here, you will assign the correct height to your insole. If you have a pes planus, it is possible the insole should be lower in total than a pes cavus. We advise you to pay extra attention to the height of the medial arch, but you will still be able to adjust it if a preview is shown at a later stage. To create a preview of our full contact 3D insole, we move on to step 5, preview 3D. It will take a couple of seconds to generate an insole. The time it takes depends on your settings and hardware. The preview will be shown in the middle. To have a better idea of how the insole looks, the screen can be rotated by the top green button on the left toolbar. Move the mouse to the screen and hold the left mouse button while moving your mouse around. This will rotate the screen. To go back to the top view, use the middle green button on the left toolbar. If the insole is not as intended, and the scan has moved, the preview needs to be updated. This can be done with step 6, update 3D. It is possible to choose only one side to speed up the process. When the insole is correct, select step 7, accept 3D. The preview will be gone, and the insoles will turn white. You can check your full contact insole by selecting show mesh with the left mouse button, which will make your 3D scans reappear. They can be hidden by using the right mouse button and selecting Show Mesh again. As you can see, the big toe is a bit deeper and can be corrected by selecting Flatten Front Foot. If needed, an element can be added in step 8, Add Elements. An element can be selected or deselected by clicking on it with the left mouse button and added to the file by pressing Next. As you can see, the element's position starts on the ground and can be adjusted to the right height with step 9, flow elements. This will automatically lay the element on top of the insole just like you would if you did it manually. If needed, the elements can be trimmed at the edges of the pattern with step 10, trim elements, and exported with step 11, export. Thank you for watching this LutraCAD introduction video. Please feel free to contact us if you have any questions regarding LutraCAD.